My son once asked me, "Dad, why should I pray? Have you seen God? And what will I get if I see God?" These were questions that were so genuine from his heart, and I had to answer them somehow. Even I never asked my dad these kind of questions. Whatever he told me, I just followed it religiously. This made me read around, and one thing which really I felt very good about was the definition of God. See, to make a pot of clay, we all need clay. We all need somebody who has the ability to make it. We need his actual talent to make it, and then he should have even the intention to make it. To make a small pot of clay, we need so many things. Then, do you think the world formed by itself? It can never happen like that, right? If you think so, then you are just trying to fool around. So somebody made this sun, the stars, the moon, the galaxy. The whole world was generated by some supernatural power. And the power did not sleep after making it. He started to operate it. The sun rises every day. The sun sets every day. We eat food and it gets converted to blood. Where in the world can a scientist make one drop of blood from the food we eat? It can never happen. So the operation also is happening constantly and continuously. And after that, suddenly you find there are droughts, suddenly you find there are floods, suddenly you find the guy slept but did not get up in the morning. So there is destruction also happening continuously and constantly. So friends, this definition of God, generator, operator and destructor, made a very good combination to explain to my son that there is one supreme entity who does all these three things, and we need to bow to him, thank him every day and tell him that it is because of you that everything is happening in this world. So get connected to the supreme soul. Have a lovely day. Thank you.